This is test flight number 55 and 56, and we are testing the operational characteristics of the power plant system. After our last flight, where we had the ESC overtemp and shut down, we have since installed a cooling system for the ESC, and we're going to give two flight tests today to validate that it's functioning as it should. I'm not even. Yep. We'll have two flights today, and on the first one we will be operating the power plant system at about 50% power. And then on the second flight we're going to bump the power up to 60 to 65% power. Once we have completed the two flight tests, we will download the data from the ESC and the other two flight data recorders on board and analyze the results.
Cameras are running. I think that one's running. Okay, so we're gonna do our regular 40 mile an hour. It looks like the wind's about 3 to 5. I'm ready. Hit it. Hit it.
Ideal tow conditions today with about a 3 to 5 mile per hour wind, which at 40 miles per hour gives us almost 1500 foot a minute rate of climb on the initial launch. We're going to tow today to about 800 foot above the ground and before we cut loose and turn the electric sustainer motor on. Initially, we powered up to about 40% power, and then as we turn on to the downwind, we'll bump the power up to about 50%. The airplane is an absolute joy to fly, and I love it every chance that I get to be in the air with it. It's really nice to be able to take your hands off the controls and not have to worry about the airplane going anywhere. On this initial flight, we've got the power set at about 50%. That's not enough to sustain flight indefinitely, but it certainly extends the flight quite substantially, as you'll see. How ironic. The purpose for the entire test flight was to test the cooling system that we've installed on the ESC. And you'll notice I reach up to the dash suddenly as I remember that I forgot to turn the cooling system fans on. Unfortunately, I don't have any way to monitor the ESC temperatures in flight. The only way that we gather that data is by downloading the ESC flight data recorder after each flight. I do, however, have motor temperature that is coming through the Eagle Tree system, and I can watch that in flight. And on the first flight, we were showing motor temperatures about 170 degrees, and the outside temperature this morning is already about 90 degrees. So far on the flight, we've been flying at a very consistent power setting. The reason for this is so that we can gather some very consistent data from the ESC to see truly how the cooling system that we've installed is functioning. Once we get down to about 300 feet, it's time to start planning for the landing. These are all test flights that we're doing, and as a result, you never know what's going to happen, so we stay within close proximity of the landing area during the entire flight. We decided on the initial test flights that we're going to leave the motor running temporarily after each flight so that we can use the motor-mounted fan to draw air through the motor for cooling purposes. Since we are simply going to take the aircraft back to the launch site and launch one more time, we'll leave the motor running until we launch once again. As we push the aircraft back to the launch site, the tow vehicle is grabbing the aircraft end of the rope and will bring it back to the aircraft. This total turnaround time takes about 5 minutes.
to 160 on the motor temp. Yeah, we should be good once we get to the top of the arc. You're pulling me, dude. Okay. Okay, hit it.
We bump the power up to about 65% power. aircraft around at about 65% power, and I'm noticing that the motor temperatures are now starting to approach 180 to 185 degrees. This is a bit more than what we want to experiment with on these early flights, so we're going to go ahead and reduce the power setting and start working our way back towards the ground. This is going to be the last flight of the day. We'll just go ahead and land the aircraft long, and then using a little bit of power, we can taxi the aircraft right up to the hangar before we come to a stop.